A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 20th April, on the front page you have Pragya stirs a row with curse on Karkare, backtracks later. So this is regarding Pragya Singh Thakur, who has now been given BJP ticket. She is fighting elections from Bhopal, and she made derogatory comments against May 26/11 terror attack martyr Hemant Karkare. And later she backtracked her statement. Even BJP said these are her personal views, and Congress sought apology from the Prime Minister. She's an accused in Hindu terror attack case. And this is poll bonds benefited BJP the most, cut cash component of donations. So this is regarding, then this is under trial branded with Om symbol. So this is a case which has come forth in Tihar jail. An under trial alleges that he was beaten up and branded with Om symbol on his back by prison superintendent in his office. So Delhi court has ordered inquiry in this case against the Tihar jail official. And this is election commission imposes 48-hour ban on Himachal BJP chief. So this is again a restraining order being put against a BJP Himachal chief for using expletive against Rahul at a rally. So election commission is using its powers now. Then below you have chemists and druggists are passed. Now, from now, all will be pharmacies. So this is a term which is said to have been first coined in 1945, chemists and druggists. Now, the Union Health Ministry has decided that all will be called pharmacies. Drug is generally considered as, you know, clandestine chemical, which is addictive. So they would not be called druggists anymore. All would be called pharmacies now. So here you can see the issue has been deliberated upon and this has been decided. So no more druggists and chemists, they all would be pharmacies. On page 5 you have traders and politicians slam government for suspension of cross LOC trade. So Home Ministry has said that the channeling of funds for terror groups drug trade was the case, as they had said earlier, because of which the cross LOC trade has been suspended between Kashmir under Indian control and Pakistan occupied Kashmir. So it has been criticized by politicians as well as traders. Then this is Ganga has higher proportion of antibacterial agents study. So this is a study which says that the isolated components in the Ganga hold great potential as an antibacterial pharmaceutical. Then this is Supreme Court to hear petition to end write-offs. So this write-off of loans which takes place. So a loan write-off basically is not a loan waiver or the loanee exempted from repaying the loan, but the banks write off the loan. They make other arrangements for the non-performing asset which has not been giving it yield. So this is the case before the Supreme Court, which is asking banks to restrain from writing off non-performing assets. Also, it wants to ban loan waivers in manifestos. Politicians announcing, political parties announcing loan waivers. Then below you have Navy to take part in fleet review in China. So this is an event which will be held in Qingdao in China, and Indian Navy is sending two ships here to take part in this international fleet review, while Pakistan is not participating in the event. And this is Goa youth questions minister on job held. So this was a youth who was arrested in North Goa after questioning local MLA and health minister Vishwajit Rane for not being given employment at a BJP campaign meeting for the party's candidate. So here you can see the youth was arrested and Congress has condemned the arrest as such and calls it misuse of power. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Saffron Error. So this is regarding BJP fielding Pragya Singh Thakur as such for the elections, and this the editorial says is for all the wrong reasons. So she is a Hindu terror attack accused as such. And she has been, here you can say, two blasts at Maligaon, the Samjhata Express bombing, explosions of Mecca Masjid in Hyderabad and Ajmer Dargah were all linked to Hindu group called Abhinav Bharat. NIA has had neither the political backing nor the ability to obtain the convictions, but she was an accused in these cases. Then this is humanize the law. So this is regarding India Forest Act, the draft India Forest Act, which has been which has been put forth. It is actually bureaucratic law, and the editorial says that the law needs to be humanized. The Indian Forest Act has to be redrawn to rid it of bureaucratic approach, because forests in colonial times were seen as British government territory ownership, and it should be actually not the case. It should be close relation between the people in living in the forest and adjoining the forests, and also playing a role in preserving them. So that even the draft Indian Forest Act of 2019 must be redrawn is what this editorial is calling for. The lead article, either way the news is bad. So this is regarding IMF loan which Pakistan proposes to take. It says if Pakistan does not take IMF loan, it is in a mess. If it does, it is in a bigger mess. So this is regarding Pakistan's economic crisis here. And this is dialogue with our fragile past. So this article argues that the world needs to look differently at its historical memory and the cultural heritage which embodies it. So this is in the context of Notre Dame Cathedral too. So it says that the past and the present has to peacefully coexist. So witnessing the past and, you know, becoming aware of a landscape of memory and the past existed, and the future, looking at the present and the future, is what is required. So he says that this awareness regarding peaceful existence between the past and the present, heritage seen as, you know, expression of joy, you know, heritage should express joy of witnessing the past despite the sadness of its historical destruction. So he says that this awareness is the strongest evidence of victory of peaceful existence between past and present, and this is how we should peacefully coexist. The Notre Dame would also have the organ pipes reverberating through the sanctuary one day again. Then Ground Zero coverage, which is there on Saturdays on op-ed page, this is regarding the elections now. The constituency in Thiruvananthapuram, which has been chosen by the BJP as launchpad in Kerala. So three-way contest between Hindutva, Hinduism and communism is taking place. This is fine. Then on international page here, you have the Robert Mueller report with USA. So this 448 page report has been out, and this is the detail regarding this, what the Mueller report says. This is important a little because of, you know, this linked to how Russia influenced US presidential elections in 2016 and whether President Trump tried to stall investigation into the case. This is now bilateral ties not linked to India's stance on Belt and Road Initiative. So this is what China says. So we see progress after Wuhan meet, and India-China relations are not hinged on Belt and Road Initiative, which India opposes. Then this is journalist killed during Northern Ireland riots. So this is Lyra McKee. She died as such. She's a journalist and author, and she was reportedly killed by dissident Republican as such. So this has been treated as a terror incident by UK police, and investigation is going on. On business page, you have top IT firms under threat of cyber attack. So criminals may be targeting top IT firms like Infosys, Cognizant, because Wipro saw a phishing attack. So now security website Krebs on Security says that other IT firms may be, top IT firms may be under threat. And this is Banks Board Bureau tags 75 officers for leadership role in public sector banks. So Banks Board Bureau, which is the apex body for selection of full-time directors of public sector banks. So it has identified 75 senior management personnel as such to take over leadership role in future. And on the last page, you have cases of measles show alarming rise, warns World Health Organization. So this has been in prominently news. We have already covered it as such too, that global data shows a jump of 300% in the first 3 months of 2019 in number of measles cases compared to the same period last year. So this is a worldwide phenomenon, that number of measles cases have been rising. In India too, we saw MMR vaccine has been pushed for, which targets measles as well. So that is important. So this is a very important issue presently, you should know about it. So that is it. Thank you.